There is a pulley, light, smooth pulley. There is a string passing over the pulley connecting the two blocks with masses M2 and M3. Another string connects a block of mass M1 with the block of mass M2, given M1 plus M2 is greater than M3. And the pulley is light and smooth. That means the mass of the pulley can be neglected and there is no friction. When the mass of the pulley is neglected, or you can even call it as massless, the pulley does not rotate. Why? Because if the pulley has to rotate, it has to have rotational kinetic energy. When it has to have rotational kinetic energy, it should have moment of inertia. Also, it should have omega, because rotational kinetic energy is half I omega square. If it should have moment of inertia, it should have mass. Okay, so the pulley does not rotate, only the string simply passes over the pulley, slides over the pulley when the blocks move, without any rotation for the pulley. We understood this. We will label the blocks. And one more thing, because the right, it's given M1 plus M2 greater than M3, right side is heavier, so the axle, the blocks will move down this side. That is acceleration of the blocks to the right side of the pulley downward, and that to the left side of the pulley will be in the upward direction. We will label the blocks now as body 1, body 2, body 3. And what we are supposed to find, acceleration of the blocks, which will be same for all the three blocks, tension 1, T1 here, this string's tension, and T2, this tension of this string, which is passing over this pulley. There are three unknowns. You require three equations. From each free body diagram, you will get one equation. You can draw three free body diagrams for body 1, body 2, body 3. Then with the three equations, you can solve for A, T1 and T2. That is the usual method. Okay. Now we will go to the free body diagram for body 1. FBD means free body diagram. Actually, what is a free body diagram? A free body diagram of a body is one in which the various forces acting on the bodies are shown, and not the force that this body exerts on others. That should not be shown. Right? So free body diagram for body, FBD means free body diagram of body 1. What are the various forces acting on this body? You see this one. Tension is acting up, weight of the body acting down. Because the acceleration is downward, M1g should be greater than T1. So the resultant will provide the resultant force here. So the equation obtained is M1g minus T1 is M1a. M1a net force. A is the corresponding acceleration. We got one equation successfully. Then what we should do, we go to the next equation by considering free body diagram of body 2. Here T2 up, T1 is down, M2g down, acceleration down. Therefore, T1 plus M2g should be greater than T2. So M2g plus T1 minus T2 is M2a. This is another equation we obtained from the free body diagram for body 2. We need one more equation, so go to the free body diagram for body 3. Tension up in this case, M3g down, acceleration is up, so T2 will be greater than M3g. So T2 minus M3g is equal to M3a. This is the third equation. So we are supposed to find A, T1 and T2 with the help of these three equations. What we can do, take this central equation here. Substitute for T1 from the equation 1. Eliminate for T1 from equation 1, substitute here. Similarly, eliminate for T2 from equation 3, substitute here. Then this equation will contain only acceleration. You can find acceleration, the first unknown. Okay, we'll do that. So take second equation, M2g as it is, plus T1. T1 will be M1g minus M1a, minus as it is. T2 will be M3g plus M3a. This minus is written here, then only T2 you'll have to substitute. This M2a as it is. Then you expand it. M2g, M1g minus M1a here, because there's minus outside this bracket, minus M3g minus M3a is equal to M2a. All g terms you take to left side, all a terms to the right side. M2g plus M1g minus M3g. This M3a will go to right side, this M1A will go to right side. This M2A is there already on the right side. So M2A plus M1A plus M3A. In this G constant, G same. So you take outside. M2 plus M1 minus M3 into G. Here A is common, you take it outside. Here G is common, so we took G outside. Here A is common, we took A outside. Supposed to find A. So A is equal to M1 plus M2 minus M3 divide by M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. So we have found the first unknown. Go to the steps of finding T1. From equation 1, T1 is equal to M1 into G minus A. M1 as it is, G as it is. For A you use this. M1 plus M2 minus M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. That is T1 is equal to M1 into G. Here you see G is out. G is common, you can take outside. M1 into G, 1 minus M1 plus M2 minus M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3. So M1 plus M2 plus M3, there is minus symbol here. So minus M1 minus M2 plus M3. Denominator of course is M1 plus M2 plus M3. So T1 is equal to M1G into, that is plus M1 minus M1, add up, they add up to 0. That is M2 minus M2, they also add up to 0. That is plus M3 plus M3, 2M3. So 2 into M3, M1 is there, G has been written. Right? So this one, you can follow this. No, M1G, 2M3. Then M1 plus M2 plus M3. Convenience sake, you write it as 2 into M1 M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. Therefore, T1 is 2 M1 M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. Now, we'll go to find T2. Follow these steps for finding T2. From equation 3, T2 is M3 into G plus A. M3 as it is, G. For A, M1 plus M2 minus M3, M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. That is for A. G common, M3G. 1 plus M1 plus M2 minus M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3. G has been already taken out. So this M3G as it is. Take M1 plus M2 plus M3 LCM. So M3G. So you get in the numerator M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M1 plus M2 minus M3. This minus M3 has come here. Then minus M3 plus M3 will add up to 0. So you will have 2 into M1 plus M2 here on the numerator. Already M3G is there, so simplify. T2 equal to 2 into M1 plus M2, this M3, this G. Denominator M1 plus M2 plus M3, as it is. Is it clear? Now, we have found acceleration T1 and T2 already. Next, what we will do, we will compare the results with the case of having a pulley with only two blocks, which we already finished in one of the earlier videos. So now we will proceed. This is a diagram giving all the summary for a two block system. This being M1, this being M2, M1 greater than M2, acceleration is given as M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. Tension is given as 2 M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. It's a two block system. We already finished in one of the earlier videos, or I will give the link also in the description. Okay. Now this is the summary of the results in this video. Acceleration M1 plus M2 minus M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. T1, 2 M1 M3 by M1 plus M2 plus M3 into G. T2 is 2 into M1 plus M2 into M3 G divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3. The spaces are left here because some more explanations will come here. Now we'll see how these things will simplify to these things. But here you will have to be very careful because here M2, here M3, here M1, here M2. So you will have to correspondingly verify. And accordingly, you can easily appreciate the results of this becoming equal to the result of this. Now what we will do, we take up first this expression for acceleration. We will make M1 0, M2 0, M3 0 in succession and see how this reduces this acceleration and the corresponding interpretations. So what we'll do, you make M10. When you make M10, what is the acceleration? Make M10. M10 means what? Now the system changes into, it changes into a block with a pulley with two blocks, because you made M10. So make M10 in this, the acceleration expression M2 minus M3 by M2 plus M3 into G. Now how do you verify this and this are same? When M1 is 0, replace M2 by M3, because M2 by M3, and also M1 by M2. Here M1 means here M2. This is not there, of course. So what do you get in this? M2 minus M3, because replace M1 by M2. So M2 minus M2, you have to replace by M3. So minus M3. Okay, when you make the substitution M10. Now in the same expression for acceleration, substitute M20. M20 means M1 minus M3 by M1 plus M3 into G. Right? But when you make M20 means this is to be made 0. Now also it becomes a system of two blocks. So you replace M2 by M3. This M1 should be equal to, because now you made M20. The M1 should be equal to M1. So leave M1 as it is. So for M20, you follow these instructions, these steps. Replace M2 by M3, M2 by M3, and M1, because M2 made 0. So leave M1 as it is. Go to this expression for acceleration. Replace M2 by M3, M1 as it is. M1 minus M3 divide by M1 plus M3 into G. M1 minus M3 by M1 plus M3 into G. Have you got this? When you make M3 0, in this expression, M30, so M1 plus M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. M1 plus M2, M1 plus M2 will cancel, A equal to G. That means it will be under free fall. Acceleration will, because this side there is no weight. So the blocks M1 and M2, body 1 and body 2, will move down with acceleration due to gravity. Right? M30, here correspondingly M2 should be 0. So this will move down with acceleration due to gravity, with an acceleration equal to acceleration due to gravity. So we have analyzed this expression by making M10, M20, M30, and all these expressions reduce to this expression for acceleration. Understood this? Now we take up T1 and do the same thing. So M1 is 0, T1 will be 0, because this, there is no block here. So tension should be 0 for this. If M1 is 0, 2M1 M3 by M1 plus M2, 2M1 M3 by M2 plus M3 into G should be equal to 0. Because you make M1 0, this will be 0. That is, tension in the string will be 0. T1. Okay? Now go to the next one. For T2. T2 M1 is 0. 2M2 M3 by M2 plus M3 into G. T2 is the tension here. Please note that this tension should be same as the tension here. Now we go to the tension expression, but where you will have to substitute M10. M10 means follow these ideas. Replace M2 by M3, replace M1 by M2, 2 M2 M3 by M2 plus M3 into G. So you are getting in this expression for T2, M1 is 0. So 2 M2 M3 by M2 plus M3 into G. See, these two will be same if you make these changes. When you put M10, okay, got this idea already. Now you make M20 in this. So 2M1 M3 by M1 plus M3 into G. M20 means follow this guideline. That is, in this M1 you leave as it is, replace M2 by M3. So 2M1 M3 by M1 plus M3 into G. That's what you got here by applying this M20 here. Is it clear? And moreover, when you make this substitution, M20, your T1 also should be equal to T2. Is it clear? M3 is 0, then T1 is equal to T2 is equal to 0. M3 is 0. Here M2 should be 0 correspondingly. Take this expression. In this you make M3 0. So T2 will be 0. Here you make M3 0, T1 will be 0. M3 0 means M2 0. Therefore, M2 0. T will be 0. Is it clear? Like, subscribe, write your comments. Thank you.